Psychologist and a corporate trainer. We have with us Mrs. Indu Vadhva. We will be shortly be joined by Mr. Rohit from Maruti. He is just on his way, and Mr. Neeraj Sharma from Investors Forum India. So, after having heard from the Bhishma Pitamaha, now it's the turn to have something from the budding Arjunas. So I would like to invite Manish Pathakji right away, who has been setting out revolutionary practices in order to create a 360-degree employee engagement, recognition, and collaboration platform at workplace, so that if there is any retention or tension, so it can be dissipated quite well in time. More we will listen from him directly. Manish.
What Raghav told, I won't be talking about what we do, but just one liner. Trigger is organization. We are into product, software product that we created for employee entire life cycle within the organization. So big corporates, basically they buy this software, they deploy it in their organization. But my major discussion point is not going to be marketing my product here. Meeting with the issues, meeting with the professors has been one of the thing I enjoy, because they have taken a lot of toll on my during my college days. I used to be there and you used to be here, so now enjoy being here, you being there. So that's there. But basically, when people were talking about it, something came to my mind. A small thing about me: I am a graduate of BIT Mesra, joined Government of India CDOT. 6 months, I realized I am not meant for government organization. Left the job, joined TCS, stayed there for 4 or 5 years, came back, joined HCL, and finally I decided to start my own company. So I became an entrepreneur. During this entire phase, while I was in TCS, we used to go to campuses for recruitment. And I was hardly 2 years in the job, so we used to go for the first round of interview, technical interview. I was the person who used to reject most of the people, go to the college, first ask them the first question what somebody was talking about: what do you know about TCS? Who started IT revolution in India? People are numb, nothing. I used to say no before I go to any technical question. So my HR head used to call me in the some cabin with a cup of coffee and some biscuits: Manish, why are you rejecting everybody? And I was like, sir, they are not even fulfilling that 70% criteria. Then he tells, okay, what is the criteria for you? I told him 30%. He says, okay, take if somebody is above 30%. So I was like, okay, the criteria is defined for me. So they had some arrangement, as somebody rightly talked about, that okay, the company will come and they will take these many people. I stayed there for 5 years. 3 years I went to USA, came back, went to Australia, came back. Again, I went to for interviews when I was in India. So this time I was a bit senior, so I used to go for the second or final round with the HR sitting with me. And there I realized that my say will be the final say. If I say no, it will be no, because I was heading this entire project. And then I started interacting with TPOs also. So few terminologies that came to my our discussion was, we have a huge inventory. I was like, inventory? Okay. So graduates are inventory. Good. Then came that, okay, we have a huge supply. We can supply you a lot of manpower whenever you need, whenever you demand. I was like, okay, so you can supply. So you are a supplier. You are a person with inventory. Somebody from real estate might be telling me this, I would have been happy. Inventory. So I was like, okay. Then I started, because I was never a good person in terms of TPO officers. Because I was blunt. I asked them, okay, what is your role here? You ever interacted with this person who spent 4 years, 4 precious years of his life in your college? When was the first time you met him? Typically, you meet him in the final year. That too, if you are good. Otherwise, you don't meet him. You meet colleges because you have to clean and clear your inventory. Sir was talking about a lot of things, which academia has to do, which industry has to do. These are big steps. Setting up collegium, setting up some kind of a tie-up and everything. It will take its own sweet time. It will happen. Right? But meanwhile, what are you doing? Somebody innocent, 10 plus 2 guy, comes, enters a college. How you treat him? A new item added to our inventory. You work, you talk about targets. So I happened to see one of my friend, he runs a very good college, and I happened to see one of the TPO officer's resume, and he was telling whatever he had written, so many of you might be writing in your resume somewhere, fantastic contact with these many campuses, these many institutes, these many companies, placed these many students, was successfully placing B grader and C grader students also to A grader companies. I was like, oh my god, so there's a whole lot of conspiracy going on. But what are you doing end of the day? You are trying to do something, a shortcuts, what somebody was talking about. Trying to find shortcuts. Because TNP is a separate department than people who are teaching students, faculty. So you are not faculty. You are not management. Who are you? 4 years, what did this student do in the college? He spent time with somebody else, and for his future, you are there deciding, okay, where should he go? I'll tell you my experience now. So when I used to go to recruit from on behalf of HCL, we used to get 5-star treatment. Fantastic. Okay, his team is coming and they will be taking at least 70 people. And we used to interact with TNP people and they used to say, we expect you will be taking at least, how many people you will be taking? So anyway, so HR always knew about me. So they used to talk. And they say, okay, whatever we will do and etc, etc. Even if I have rejected, they try to find some merits and they try to take people. It was fine, no problem. But when I started my company, so it started with 2 TCSers. We had a lot of time in USA with a client location. Within 3 hours, we used to complete our job, which Americans, typical normal Americans rightly said, used to take 8 hours. We used to finish everything in 3 hours. And our management was rigid. Don't finish everything in one day. Otherwise, how can we bill him for 6 months? So you had a lot of time for coffee. So point was, ghost billing I'm not talking about. I'm talking about authentic billing. And they used to tell, you have to, you know, loosen yourself. Don't be so fast. Expected time for delivery of this project is 3 months. How can you complete in 2 weeks? And he was like, okay, sir, then give us coffee breaks. Right? So me and Paras, my friend, my partner right now, we used to go and sip coffee. One fine day we decided, yeah, let us go back to India, start our own company. We came back. And we got initially friends, family kind of a people, some references. Then first time we went to one college here. There I used to go as part of HCL also. But now I went from a startup. So I go there, junior TNP officer. There was a new person. He told me, I'm TNP executive. Came to meet you. Good, no problem. I will go and talk to the students. So students sat there. We told them what we are. We are a startup with 6 people. Now we are 24 people. Now I'm promoted in another company. We are another company we have started. I have started with my brother. It is into waste management. So we told them about our company. And first thing was, okay, people who are not interested can leave. And typically we used to ask for the dates when some big company is coming. Some Sony or some other company. So finally we'll have some 20, 30 people staying there. We'll go and talk, okay, who are 6 pointers, 7 pointers, 8 pointers, 9 pointers. Then the first question used to be, what is trigger in the room? People who were able to answer, in the same answer, me and Paras and there was another girl in our team, we should identify, okay, these are the people we think that they finally will go into the final round. Because we are very picky and choosy in taking people. Because we are startups, we don't have bench strength, we don't have, because 70% people in TCS kind of companies, we knew about it. I was heading a team of 70 people. 70% of people, I didn't even know their name. They are there for billing sake. Less than mediocres also, they will survive. Right? And there it happens, okay, once ek bar aa gaya project mein chalta hai yaar, koi baat nahi. Raghav is very intelligent, he will take care of it. Right? They don't even know. But startups, you need to have people who are good. So we took people from IIPM 3 years ago. We took 3 of them. 2 of them became entrepreneur after working with us for 1.5 years. And these 2 companies, one could not survive, one survived, and they are employing close to 30 people right now. I went to the same college next year. They had a fantastic board where you place photograph of your top rankers, where you place data, top recruiters, TCS 340, XYZ company. So all that data was there. Trigro's name was nowhere mentioned. Right? It's fine. No issue because you have a constant of space. Then they had chart makers wall of fame kind of thing, students who are making big and high. That student who we employed, who got trained with us for 1.5 years, he knew everything about starting an organization. What somebody was talking about, that is, doctor can start his own clinic day one, but an engineer can't do it, or a professional can't do it. So they can't do it because they are not exposed to all those things. In a startup, they are exposed to everything. They are supposed to do from opening the shop to closing the shop to making a business presentation to writing the code to selling it, everything they are supposed to do. As a startup, Raghav might be knowing, or his team members might be knowing about it. So they are exposed to everything. So that is the reason two people, when they left our company, they did not go to join any other company, they started their own company. And finally, one of the person has employed 30 people. So with our one employment, we generated 30 new employments. His name was not in the master role. You are not celebrating your success stories. Who are your success stories? Not TCS, not Infosys, not Trigero. Your success stories are your students who are going and making big into the corporate arena. Are you sharing their success stories? You might be. If somebody happens to be after 25 years becoming MD or CEO of some company, you will celebrate that. But are you creating role models in your college, in your campus? That comes in the part of, I think, I believe, and you have all the right to differ, training and placement or whatever you call. Because your job is to create role models. Your job is to create, show that our students are self-sufficient. This is what they have. This is how they achieve targets. If that is not there, your job stops the moment you supply that, you clear that inventory, your job stops because next inventory is ready. So probably, and it is not entirely your own personal mistake or something, it's a system. Because the colleges where I have been to, so many colleges, the way they run, it's more like a corporate organization where basically, you know, you have to have these many students coming and these many students going. And we celebrate numbers. 1146 students placed in top A and B category companies. Do you ever celebrate anybody who started his own organization, who became an entrepreneur? Now at few colleges it had started happening. So entrepreneurship sale is happening. Why don't you create that? In US, in India also, we might have talked about 2.2 lakh jobs being offered to engineers. What happens to those rest of 8 lakh people? Are they on the street? No. Because if they will be on the street, every year you will have 8 lakh people on the street. They get inducted in some or other job. Who is providing those jobs? Companies like us. 59 million people are working in MSME or sector. A data which I recently just now saw in this book. In United States, IBM is not the biggest employer. If you have heard about Obama's speech, he's talking about the entire economy of United States is running because of startups, entrepreneurs. And they employ people, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. But the number of enterprise is huge. And that employs maximum number of people. But what is your, as a college, as an institute, what is your attitude towards them? What is the attitude you inculcate in the students in your campus? Do you tell them that the most challenging task is not what you completed in the 4 year. Most challenging task is what you are going to learn in next 2 years. And if next 2 years you happen to go into a big organization, you will learn to make this, but only this part, because you are not exposed to the entire architecture of this podium. Probably you will learn how to do the finishing. If you are working in a small organization where you are being exposed to everything and anything, that is the on-the-job training. If you inculcate this thing, your students are not being needy, not being angry with you that you are not able to place them. They will value the culture of entrepreneurship, culture of startup, culture of learning. So right now what we are creating, you go into a professional college, engineering college, job is guaranteed. Ownership is not guaranteed, because ownership nobody talks about, right? Ownership people talk about when tomorrow Trigero becomes a company with 100 people, 200 people, 1000 people, then again we'll talk, people will just die for it. Another example, we went to another college this year. We hired 3 people again from that college. One of them, he left us after 1 year. Before leaving, he came and talked to me, "Manish, I want to start my own company and I'm going to start maybe 4 months down the line." So can you please groom me? Can you please tell me how to make business plans? I knew he's going to leave, but I did that. He started his own company in Lucknow, employing 7 people right now. And I made him my vendor. I gave him the first project of our client. I created 2 portions, 1 portion I gave it to him. He is very happy today. But in his college, are people aware about it? Is the TNP people, are they making him hero? That person, after leaving the college in just 2 years, he created 7 employments. You celebrate, after leaving the college, he had joined Infosys. He had joined IBM. He had joined HP, Dell, whatever. But you don't celebrate, he created 7 new employments. The day you start celebrating this, this will be your small bit that anybody and every one of us can do. Forget about forging a tie-up, NTPC will come, do a program. They will do it. Anyway, they will do it after some time, some years. But what are you trying to do? And reason, what might be the reason? I was in one of the NHRDN events. So in NHRDN events, one of the top colleges of Pune, they always participate. And I happened to talk to the head of the organization. And their students were in the voluntary kind of a thing. And it was, I'm talking about when they had it in Kingdom of Dreams, Gurgaon. So that year we wanted to go to campus to take 4 or 5 people, because everywhere we try to get some people. And so I talked to few of their students, because one of the professors told me, students are here, if you want you can just go and interact with them. I asked them, how about your management? And this lady was very courteous. She tells me that he is a fantastic person. Last year when the recession was there, or this year also when there were not so many companies coming to our campus, he called us and he told, don't worry, even if companies are not taking you, the least I will do is I will make you faculty in my college. Fantastic thing from a student's point of view. A very serious thing from the perspective of organization. The least I can do is make you faculty in my college. If you are not ready for institute, if you are not ready for organizations, you will become a faculty. Don't worry. How many of you find the same situation in your college? The kind of faculty that is going. I am part of NEN, so I go to a lot of places, train the trainer kind of thing. They call me, I talk about it. What is the kind of faculty that are coming there? If you don't find anything, we are there. So he might have told it in a very normal way, but this normalcy is the serious thing. If you are not ready for the institution, if you are not ready for the world outside and company and job, you will start training the people who are going to be ready for job, who are supposed to be ready for job next year. So this is the attitude of management. So as TNP officers, what we can do? Small steps. I won't be talking about, okay, form this academia and corporate partnership. That will happen, that there are so many people talking about it. You need to interfere. You need to raise questions. You need to create that. You need to interact with the students from day one he joins. It should be your first right to interact with them. I was called in one of the inaugural sessions of a college in Mohannagar. All the new students, 2000 plus, and they wanted few industry people to come and talk about it. I asked them, who is the TNP officer? He was not there. He's not concerned. He should be part of that induction meeting. He should be part of the curriculum every session. He should be telling what is happening outside the world. You leave them at the mercy of Google and his friends. You know what is happening outside the world. So this is something where basically your direct role is involved. Where basically you can question, you can interfere, you can go and talk to them, you can make them ready for the job. That employable, we talk about employability. And only you can do it. Even if you do it for 5 people, I think other barring those targets and everything, supply and demand, that will happen anyway. If industry will be in demand, they will come to any damn campus that is there. We talk about ABC campus. I have seen the time when we were told, I was told, Manish, take people even if they fulfill the criteria of 30% per your yardstick. Why? And I have seen the time when they were like, okay, that college is pressurizing us too much. Send Manish. Right? It used to happen because HR had a lot of pressure. So he used to send, okay, who has the worst record of hiring? Manish Bhatak. Send him. Right? So I did my obligation. TNP wala will call me. Sir, aapke bande ne liya hi nahi. Main kahunga, are main bande ko daantta hu. Mamla khatam ho jayega. Dono khush. राइट, तो अगर जरूरत होगी तो आपके यहां से ले जाएंगे, बट इफ एट ऑल यू आर एबल टू इंपैक्ट दोज फाइव पीपल्स लाइफ, बिलीव मी दे आर योर ब्रांड एम्बेसडर्स, टुमारो दे आर गोइंग टू कम टू योर कैंपस, एंड दैट टुमारो मे हैपन नेक्स्ट ईयर बिकॉज दे माइट बिकम एंटरप्रेन्योर. Only question I asked this person who went to Lucknow, how many people you are? He told me 7 people and 4 are from his college. 3 are his junior, 1 is his batchmate. I was so happy. And when he came to Delhi, he said, मेरे को project नहीं मिल रहा है. I told him, मेरे पास एक project है, मैं तुझे देता हूँ जाकर. इससे तेरा खर्च निकल जाएगा. We are a very small company, very, very small company. But this spirit is something which is important. I know at any point in time I can go to back to job again, I can find a good high flying career, I can do everything. I wanted to do some entrepreneurship, I wanted to do impact people's life, I did that. But are you celebrating those things? If you do that with 5 people, next time you will have 5 people to call personally, you will call their number. Boss, ye ho raha hai, kya ho raha hai, kya kar raha hai, koi kaam start kara, kahan ho sakta hai, 4 logon ko tumhe guide karna hai. Are you calling your students for mentoring who went to the organization? No. Very few colleges, or I can say no, nil colleges. There are few colleges who always wanted to call me. मैं जाकर उनसे पूछा कि आपके एक्स स्टूडेंट्स कहाँ पर हैं, होंगे कहीं पर, कोई मोजरबेर में काम कर रहा होगा, कोई होंडा में काम कर रहा होगा, आपको डेटा भी नहीं है उसका पता. दे आर योर बिगेस्ट स्ट्रेंथ, आप वो नहीं कर रहे हो. सो एज टीएनपी स्टार्ट इंटरफेयरिंग, दैट इज वॉट आई बिलीव दैट माइट बी हेल्पफुल. स्टार्ट इंटरफेयरिंग, बिकम अ पैटर्न, बिकम अ फ्रेंड, फिलोसफर एंड गाइड फॉर स्टूडेंट्स, बिकॉज फैकल्टी दे माइट नॉट बी एबल टू टॉक लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स, फैकल्टी हैज देयर ओन fatal problems, but you will have, you are supposed to be a kind of a bridge between industry, his future and his present. So be there with them rather than going to campuses. That okay, anyway they can, it's a part of your job, you'll go, but at least try to mentor 5 students from each batch every year. So the moment you become mentor, a part of your job will be done, and a satisfaction that comes by writing this, the day you will start writing, or suppose if I am a TNP, I will write that I mentored 200 students out of my 20 years of career, that is going to be a success criteria. Any company you go there, any person who is going to hire young TNP people, they know about your background, how it will be done, dynamics are different. But what basically gives you satisfaction, what basically gives me satisfaction is, I created some job, people who are leaving my organization, they are not going to go into some job somewhere. They are going to start his own company, and that is a good thing. That's where basically strength lies. So that is my statement, that's my talk, that's what I wanted to talk about. Thanks a lot. If you have a question, you can ask me.
I have a question, sir.
My name is Manish, sir. Call me Manish.
Decision is not lies to them that they have to start a new company, or they can club with 4 or 5 people and they can start the company. Because what I can say, primarily their parents are involved in this, and there is a sort of amount which is required from the parents itself, because government is also not giving a loan without any type of things which is required. So at a very reality point or reality grounds, parents want that the person should get a job, get experience in that, and then after the performance, they allow them to start their own company or something like that.
Yeah. So probably my message was not communicated. My point is not that everybody should start going and starting their own company. My point is, are you celebrating, are you creating that? Out of 2000, not everybody is from the same region. And this is not going to give you a panacea, this is not going to be a complete solution that okay, take this and entire problem is solved. My point is the small bit that you can do. Out of 2000 students that they come to your campus, are you really mentoring 5 or 6 people? Do you know? Do you have a personal connect with 4 or 5 people? At any point in time from 4-year curriculum, 20 people, you know about them, you know about their family, you know about their aspirations. You can guide them, mentor them. Okay, this is the best thing for you. Probably IT is not the best field for you. You do this. Probably even because doing a 4-year course, people who have done mechanical, they are becoming fantastic computer engineers. They are becoming fantastic artists, right? Health, fitness trainers. So it's all about attitude that you are building in this entire 4 year. So become a mentor. Celebrate success of your students who are already in the market. Try to find. The moment they leave your campus, you feel like relaxed. That mentality I'm talking about, right? I did not
put that everybody should start their own company.
Your suggestion is very good, but being a part of a management, there are certain limitations and we have to fulfill our KRAs under that limitations. So we have to act as a, you know, democracy, or you can say diplomatically, we have to handle the situations. And
that's where the personal
we have to just put things on our tongues. So once we speak up all these things that you are not meant for mechanical engineering, go and go just do some artist course or some, you know, that will be penalized.
I'll tell you one
for
thing.
That
yeah, I understand that thing, I have been part of that, but again I'll tell you one thing. What Mr. Goyal was talking about, there is something which basically you have to make a balance. I'm not talking about mentoring 20,000 or 2,000 people. I'm just talking about being connect, feel emotional about them, right? They put their future in your hand. Problem is, people with whom we entrusted our future, they are scared people like you and like me. We are scared of talking our heart out. We are scared of guiding them in right path, knowing that, okay, if beta, agar tu is par jayega, to aage girega, hum kare koi baat nahi yaar, agar ye nahi girega, to main gir jaunga. Right? Don't do this. Your role is end of the day teacher. Okay, whatever be the TNP, whatever you call, for a student 10 plus 2 jo aata hai aapke college mein, uske liye aap role model ho. Are you really a role model? Do you feel like, if you, how many people take you as a role model? That is the call. I am not talking about becoming crusader. I am talking about finding a balance. Do 5-day job for your salary, do 1 day for yourself. And I believe every one of us, it will give us more satisfaction if there is 5 students who go out and come back and touch your feet, say, sir, aapne mujhe achha bataya tha. That I do with one teacher in my college campus. Okay, so that's a small simple thing what basically happened. I will tell you a small story. Her name was Chetali. We used to have this sessional. So I wrote a sessional examination, 40 marks. She cut 10 marks out of it from her program. And I was like, okay, I'm very good in C. How can she cut 5 marks? 10 marks. So I went to meet her. Madam, aapne kahan se kaate mere number? Unhone kaha, beta, tu ek सेमीकॉलन भूल गया था. मैंने कहा मैम, आई जस्ट फॉरगॉट अ सेमीकॉलन एंड 10 आउट ऑफ 10 यू आर कटिंग. सो ही टोल्ड मी अबाउट अ स्टोरी दैट द बिगेस्ट मिस्टेक ऑफ अ सॉफ्टवेयर हैज कॉस्ट 500 बिलियन लॉस टू न्यूयॉर्क स्टॉक एक्सचेंज एंड द एंटायर लॉस वाज ड्यू टू अ हाइफन. उन्होंने कहा वो तो एक सिंगल कैरेक्टर था, तूने तो दो छोड़े थे. देन आई केम बैक, आई स्टार्टेड रीडिंग अबाउट इट एंड आई रेड अबाउट बिगेस्ट सॉफ्टवेयर फेल्यूर्स. आज भी मुझे वो याद है. सी गेव मी 8 नंबर बैक. She just cut 2 numbers. But what was the incident? If I would not have gone to her, it's fine. Main gaya, I asked her, she gave me an incident, and finally I was aware that, okay, mistake is something, it can be very costly. So those kind of teachers who basically call you, guide you, mentor you, they basically become imprint. So whenever I go to Ranchi, I make a point to meet her. Now she's no more there, she has moved to some other college, but we are in touch. So how many students are in touch with you? How many students are talking about you the way I am talking about Chetali? That is the criteria. If that happens, you are done.
Can I say something?
Sure, please.
There is a difference between teaching and non-teaching. We TNP people are not the so-called faculty or the teaching staff.
Right.
So there is a marked difference of respect, I would say, that a student would give to a faculty than a TNP. With TNP, their attitude is totally different. It's more of achievements, those who have passed out, the illuminate. So I had made a mention in mail of, you know, awards, rewards from their organization, it gave us such a proud feeling that, you know, 5 years down the line, their project manager somewhere in US, Singapore, they're doing so well.
Right.
But how many do we come?
Yeah. I'll tell you one thing. The person who comes to your college, what are you selling him first place? That's where I told you that you have to interfere. Reason being, the management sells you, TNP people, that okay, you come to our campus, do a 4-year degree, you will get a job. That's what you are selling actually. And who is supposed to do this? You. So if they are demanding this from you, they are not at mistake, because that is the something it has been shown to them before entering the campus. So you are being sold, essentially. Correct, but you are being sold to the students before they take admission. That our TNP is itna acha hai na, tere ko job dila dega turant. Right? If you are being sold, you have all the rights to tell, okay boss, we are not non-teaching staff. My point is that start interfering. I know that you are supposed to be only interfacing with the corporate. But now it's your job, because end of the day college gets admission, takes admission. Student opts for a college by seeing their campus recruitment profile. It's a very big criteria. So sell to aap ho rahe ho. वो जो 4 लाख 5 लाख आप बता रहे हो वो किसके लिए दे रहा है? वो आपके लिए दे रहा है. जब आपके लिए दे रहा है और आपको उसके 4 साल में कोई राइट ही नहीं है बोलने का, दैट इज वेयर बेसिकली यू नीड टू रेज योर हैंड्स.
Calling people like you, startup ventures, CEOs coming and talking, but really had no impact on the side of management or the directors. They would directly ask, ki aap ye batao kitne bachche entrepreneur bana loge? Ye awareness to theek hai. Aap venture capitalist ya angel investors ko bula to loge, venture capitalist nahi, angel investor.
Mm-hmm.
But usse kya, hamare ka incubation center start ho jayega?
Okay. So
that's
that is the reason we are talking about this has become an issue. So I am not talking about those colleges where the management has, why they have started the college, that is in question. So those kind of places, I can only tell you as a colleague, not a right place for people like us, spirited people like us. Right? There are good institutions in private sector also, in small colleges. I have been to small colleges. I have talked to management. They have started. They are probably builders also. But at least they have some sense why they have started it. So now it all depends where you are stuck, where we are talking about. I am talking about a general thing which basically appeals me as a student. If I would be a 10 plus 2 student coming to your college, seeing you, who can be my role model? Faculty who could not find a job, or TNP people who don't interact with me for the entire year,
yep,
who are sold to me. So those kind of things. So I talked about interfere, claim your rightful position in the organization. And any management, end of the day, what are the options they have? They have already invested 10 crore rupees. The way, I will tell you a simple example. We got first investment. After a lot of struggle, we got first set of investment. And second round, we wanted to go and talk to them. So second round, when we asked them for investment, our pitch were different. If you don't give us, then 6 months we will be closed. We got the reply immediately. Because their money is already stuck. Right? So it was not... So it was our response was simple, because first time it took us 1 year to get the investment, second time it was the moment we wrote the letter, we got a call, we are lending to Delhi, let us meet and let us see what is the cash flow, blah blah blah. So now their money is stuck. Only you need to open up, you need to talk to them, right? End of the day, you have to decide what is the kind of place you want to choose for yourself. If you feel like, okay, I can tolerate this, it's fine. If you speak out, probably so many times it's a fear. Fear of unknown. You go and talk to them. I feel like this is going to happen. They will be happy if they have not, if they don't need to pay you extra. Right? And you don't want this. End of the day, after 10 years or 10 years down the line, 10 students remembering you as a person, that okay, they guided me. They don't remember ki mere professor kaun the, teacher kaun the. College mein ek librarian ko log yaad rakh lete hain. Wo aapko achhe achhe books batata hai. C++, don't go for this. Don't go for Kanitkar. Go for this particular book. So, wo yaad rehti hain cheezein. You need to define आपको क्या करना है. बड़ी चीजें आप नहीं कर सकते, हम तुरंत बैठकर नहीं कर सकते. ये इको सिस्टम है, डेवलप होते होते करेगा. 40 साल से ये शायद बात हो रही है, एकेडमी को ये करना चाहिए, वो करना चाहिए, वो IIT तक जाते आते थक जाते हैं लोग. ठीक है, उसके नीचे जाने में उनको एनर्जी नहीं बचती है, और जिसने स्टार्ट किया होता है वो रिटायर कर जाता है तब तक. राइट? तो नहीं होता है. हम क्या कर सकते हैं एज अ प्रोफेशनल यंग पीपल? इफ यू हैव सेलेक्टेड दिस एज अ करियर, व्हाट वी कैन वी डू? मैं उसकी बात कर रहा हूँ। ये तो प्रॉब्लम आएंगे ही आएंगे, अगर प्रॉब्लम नहीं होती तो आपको जॉब क्यों मिलती? इसकी जॉब है तो इसका मतलब प्रॉब्लम है। एंड हाउ विल यू मेक योर मार्क? अगर ये लीक बना दीजिए यही करना है, इस पूरे टेबल में सिर्फ आपको ऊपर वाली फ्लैश स्लैब बनानी है, देन यू आर इन TCS। पूरी टेबल बनानी है, देन यू आर एंटरप्रेन्योर। एंटरप्रेन्योर इज नॉट अबाउट स्टार्टिंग योर ओन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, एंटरप्रेन्योर इज अबाउट डिफाइनिंग योर ओन करियर, ओन पाथ। मैं यहीं पर हूं, मैं ऐसे ही करूंगा। मैंने वो कोशिश किसी रॉट में नहीं हुआ, मैंने छोड़ दी गवर्नमेंट जॉब। पिताजी को एक फोन करा था, पापा छोड़ रहा हूं, और बहुत अच्छा, हेल्थ कैसी तुम्हारी? आई वॉज लाइक ओके गुड। सेकेंड डे आई गॉट अ जॉब। सो दोज आर द टाइम्स, बट एंड ऑफ द डे मुझे आज अच्छा लगता है। एक बड़ी सी चीज हुई है कि हमें आजकल लगता है कि हमें जो अच्छा लगे वो करें। तो आपको अगर वो अच्छा लगेगा आप वो कीजिए। प्रेशर तो मैनेजमेंट का आएगा, उसको झेलने के लिए तुम्हारे पास एक ग्रेसल बने हुए हैं। वी नीड टू बी डिप्लोमेटिक, वी आर डिप्लोमेटिक, इसलिए मैंने सेकंड लेटर लिखा था, अगर पैसे दूसरे नहीं दोगे तो 6 महीने में कंपनी बंद हो जाएगी। तुरंत आ गया सेकंड ट्रांच विदाउट एनी डिले।
सर आई हैव वन स्टेटमेंट और रादर सजेशन। आपकी पूरी स्पीच में यू हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट द पॉजिटिव साइड एंड द नेगेटिव साइड ऑफ द TNP। व्हाट इज द रोल ऑफ TNP एंड व्हाट शुड बी द रोल? क्या उसका पॉजिटिव इम्पैक्ट पड़ेगा और क्या नहीं पड़ेगा? बीच में मैम ने भी एड्रेस किया दैट द मैनेजमेंट इज ओनली कंसर्न अबाउट द नंबर्स। सो आई पर्सनली सजेस्ट कि ये जितने भी कॉन्क्लेव्स हमारे होते हैं रिगार्डिंग HR और रिगार्डिंग रिक्रूटमेंट, द सीनियर मैनेजमेंट हैज टू बी प्रेजेंट हियर, बिकॉज अनलेस दे विल नेवर बी कन्विंस्ड विद द थिंग कि एक्चुअली TNP कुछ करता भी है, अदरवाइज दे विल नेवर बिलीव कि हमारे डिलीवरेंस क्या होती है और क्या होनी चाहिए, कितना हम काम कर रहे हैं।
दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट राघव, इनफैक्ट यू शुड इनवाइट देम, दे नीड टू बी अंडरस्टैंडिंग द पेन पॉइंट्स। अभी उनके लिए क्या है कि नंबर है, इन्वेंटरी वो क्रिएट कर रहे हैं इनके लिए, राइट? तो दे शुड बी पार्ट ऑफ सच काइंड ऑफ सिंपोजियम, इवन इफ यू हैव टू से प्लीज आ जाइए सर, बट उनको आना चाहिए। बिल्कुल सही कह रहे हैं आप, बिल्कुल सही। आई स्ट्रॉन्गली एग्री, अगर वहाँ होते तो कुछ एनलाइटन हो जाते शायद, बिकॉज पीयर प्रेशर बड़ा इंपॉर्टेंट होता है। एंड दे शुड बी देयर इन द पैनल ऑल्सो, एटलीस्ट दे विल कमिट समथिंग हियर। थैंक्स अ लॉट, आई टुक लॉट ऑफ टाइम।
No, it was a excellent deliberation. I would now invite, I would like to rather welcome Mr. Rohit Arora, Manager Human Resources from Maruti Suzuki India Limited. Mr. Rohit Arora is with us, and we also have, so I would now like to invite Mr. Neeraj Sharma, the founder of Investors Forum India, and he is quite passionate about creating employable graduates for the real estate industry. He runs a training program under the brand Path Makers, and he has been trying in that fashion, like how all these attitudinal problems of the MBAs rather and technical graduates also to an extent can be alleviated through focused workshops and training sessions. So without losing any further time, I would invite Mr. Sharma to share his experiences, his thoughts. Dr. Sharma, to please hand over a citation. Thanks.